You're so late getting home from the office. Darling, darling, did you miss your train? Were you caught in the rain? No, don't bother to explain. Can I fix you a quick martini? As a matter of fact, I'll have one with you. We see, to tell you the truth, I've had quite a day to. Guess who I saw today, my dear? I went in town to shop around for something new, and thought I'd stop and have a bite when I was through. I looked around for some place near, when it occurred to me where I had parked the car, there was this most attractive French cafe and bar. Oh, it really wasn't very far. The waiter showed me to a dark, secluded corner, and as my eyes became accustomed to the gloom, I saw two people at the bar who were so in love. Even I could spot it clear across the room. Guess who? Guess who? Guess who I saw today, my dear? Oh, I have never been so shocked before. I ran blindly for the door. They didn't see me as I was passing through. Guess who I saw today? Guess who I saw today? Guess who I saw today?
Well, I have been looking forward to this concert all year, to be able to be on stage with these amazing people. It's really great, so I hope you enjoy tonight. I hope you enjoy our fabulous furnishings, mainly from Zara's living room, but we hope it feels a little bit like you're in our lounge and we're singing to you.
And we vacuumed.
And we vacuumed. Yeah, that's where it's quite different from our house.
Been in love before. Now all at once it's you. It's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is what that's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song, and now my soul must fall. So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. In middle age, and the boys are more interested in your assets, if you ask anyone. So what if you started telling lies? I know that I overanalyze. How would it be in a year or three? You grew tired of me and we didn't agree. No, I just couldn't bear to go through it all again. Please assure me of your love sincerely. Won't you tell me that you love me dearly? I can make you believe you've never been in love before.
Introduce my amazing accompanist. Now he's kind of had a chance to show off a bit. This is Tom Rainey on the record stage. I often joke that he's my music husband. You won't, won't you? Yeah. We've been playing together for a long time. It's been great. And that's probably a bit creepy saying that since he used to be my teacher too. It's a bit creepy, but I'm a bit creepy, so that's okay. Right, we are going to do a song that I adore. Now, this is actually from an opera, but it's a Gershwin opera, so it's not really an opera, really, is it? Oh, or as Stu Buchanan used to say, written by George and his wife Ira. But no. I love you, forgive, don't let him take me, don't let him handle me and drive me mad. If you can keep me, I want to stay with you forever, and I'll be glad. Yes, I love you. drive me mad. If you can keep me, I want to stay here with you forever. I've got my man. Someday I know he's coming for me. He's gonna handle me and hold me so. It's gonna be like dying for you. But when he calls me, but when he calls, I know I'll have to go. If you can keep me, I want to stay with you forever. I've got my man.
Thank you.
I met a man without a dollar to his name, who had no traits of any value but a smile. I met a man who had no yearn or claim to fame, who was content to let life pass him for a while. And I was sure that all I ever wanted was a life like the movie stars live. Kissed me right here, and he said, I'll give you stars and the moon and a soul to guide you, and a promise I'll never go. I'll give you hope to bring out all the life inside you, and the strength that will help you grow. I'll give you truth and a future that's 20 times better than any Hollywood plot. And I thought, you know, I'd rather have a yacht. I met a man who lived his life out on the road, who left a wife and kids in Portland on a whim. I met a man whose fire and passion always showed, who asked if I could spare a week to ride with him. Said, but you don't understand. I'll give you stars and the moon and the open highway and a river beneath your feet. I'll give you days full of dreams if you travel my way and a summer you can't repeat. I'll give you nights full of passion and days of adventure. No strings, just warm summer rain. And I thought, you know, I'd rather have champagne. I met a man who had a fortune in the bank, who had retired at age 30, set for life. I met a man and didn't know which stars to thank. And then he asked one day if I would be his wife. And I looked up, and all that I could think of was the life I had dreamt I would live. And I said to him, what will you give? I'll give you cars and a townhouse, a turtle bay, and a fur and a diamond ring. And we'll be married in Spain on my yacht today, and we'll honeymoon in Beijing. And you'll meet stars at the parties I throw at my villas in Nice and Paris in June. And I thought, okay. And I took a breath, and I got my yacht. And the years went by, and I'd never changed, and I'd never grew, and I never dreamed. And I woke one day, and I looked around, and I thought, my God, I'll never have the moon. Know me knows this bit doesn't happen very often, but I'm actually going to sing with my real husband rather than my musical husband. Tom Rainey, please put your hands together for that amazing man. Now, this amazing contraption, I better show that I actually know what this is, that I have actually been listening to him when he talks about it. This is a 10-string electric bass, in case you're wondering what it is. And that's FUD, in case you're wondering what that is. Hi, darling. So we don't normally get to gig together very often because we're normally like tag at the door and the other person looks after the children while we're running off to, you know, concerts and things and rehearsals mainly. But I'm very lucky because I've actually got my mum and my children here. Hi! Now this last song was actually written by John Lennon. And the Beatles recorded, it was one of the last recorded songs by the Beatles, and it's not a very well-known one, but I found a Regina Spektor version of it, and I absolutely fell in love with it. And we were actually going to do it for a Beatles show that I pulled out of because of things. And and I was really disappointed to not be able to do this, so I thought that here's a great opportunity. So we actually met this way, by the way, over 20 years ago. Fudd asked if I would apply one of his assessments at jazz school. And I remember, and you were marking it, Tom. Are you going to hold up scorecards?
Yeah.
So it's been a while. Was it 22 years? Holy crap, I'm old. Right.
To be this moment all I know. Exactly where my life will go. Seems like all I really was doing was waiting for love. No need to be afraid. No need to be afraid. It's real love, yes, it's real love. Oh, it's real love, yes, it's real love. Thought I'd been in love before, but in my heart I wanted more. Waiting for you. No need to be alone. No need to be alone. It's real love. Yes, it's real love. Oh, it's real love. Yes, it's real love. Oh, it's real.
Well, that was lots of fun. Thank you so much. And I'd like to invite to the stage my amazing friend and colleague, Naomi. And now, are you Ferguson or Vandenbroek in this particular one? It's weird for you. It's kind of like a meeting of work and, you know, real life and fantasy performing life. Kia ora. Lovely to see you all here this evening. Thank you so much for sharing this evening with us. It's been a lot of fun in the planning, as you can well imagine, and it's a real privilege to share the evening with my wonderful colleagues, whom I respect greatly. It's a real treat for singers to be on gigs with other singers. Oftentimes we're the only singer on the show, so it's lovely to sit and listen to other beautiful singers. We're going to begin our bracket with a number written by written in the 50s by a composer who lived in New York. And I recorded this on my first album a long time ago. And I really love this song because I feel like it's... Do come in. We've got a seat for you right here on the front row. There he is. We've all been waiting. I feel like if someone ever made A Streetcar Named Desire into a musical, this would be the song that Blanche DuBois sings. Something cool, I'd like to order something cool. It's so warm here in town and the heat gets me down. Yes, I'd like something cool. My, it's nice to simply sit and rest a while. Now I know it's a shame I can't think of your name. I remember your smile. I don't ordinarily drink with strangers. I most usually drink alone. But you were so awfully nice
my dress. I must confess it's very old, but it's simple and neat. It's just right for the heat. Save my furs for the cold. A cigarette. Well, I don't smoke them as a rule, but I'll have one. It would be fun with something. Bet you couldn't imagine that I one time had a house with so many rooms I couldn't count them all. I'll bet you couldn't imagine I had 15 different foes who would beg and beg to take me to a ball. I'll bet you couldn't picture me the time quite so tall. Well, it's through. It's just a memory I had, one I almost forgot, 'cause this weather's so hot and I'm feeling so bad. About a date. Oh, wait, I'm such a fool. He's just a guy who stopped to buy me something.
I was the rude one of the three of us that didn't write about the special relationship between an accompanist and the singer and the role of modern art song. It now seems like a good idea to introduce my husband, Alex Vandenbroek, on the piano. We do have a very special relationship. Perhaps I just didn't feel the need to write about it. And of course, the best part is that we can rehearse in our pyjamas. You'll note we've made an effort tonight. This next song is by one of my favourite composers of song, an American composer called Randy Newman. A lot of you will be familiar with him from the theme song to Toy Story. And for those of you slightly older in the bunch that have listened to some satirical stuff, you may remember the stir that was caused when he wrote a song called Short People. Neither of those are the songs we're going to do tonight.
She's a real emotional girl. She wears her heart on her sleeve. Every little thing you tell her, she'll believe. She really daddy's little girl. She's a real emotional girl. She lives down deep inside herself.
Pleasure to invite my wonderful friend and colleague Mark Menzies to the stage to join us for this next number. A slightly abrupt change of pace, as you will note from the title, The Ballad of Marie Sanders, The Jew's Whore. This is a song that was written in between World War I and World War II, and is a particular favourite of mine, and I'm just going to grab a sip of water before we kick off. Giving women cause to weep who had been sleeping with the wrong man. The price is rising for butcher's meat. The drumming fills you with pride. God above, if they are coming down the street, it may be tonight. Does your lover have raven hair? If so, you better had make sure this is the end of the affair. The price is rising for butcher's meat. The drumming's now at its height. God above, here they are coming down the street. It will be tonight. Mother, give me the key, please. Things can't really be so bad. The moon's as clear as ever. And people crouch in their tenements and hear the beating of drums. God above, could there be something wrong tonight? Listen, here it comes. At 9 one morning, she is driven through the city in her slip, with a board around her neck, her head shaven, the crowd jeering, her eyes stone cold. The price is rising for butcher's meat. Strikers coming, make room, and thousands come down and lie in the streets. Strikers speaking tonight. God above, if they had heads as well as feet, they would know who it is that they should
always nice when you can just call, you know, one of the best violinists in the country up to just one song on a set. The next number we're going to do is a beautiful song written by Joni Mitchell, who is a fantastic composer and singer and musician and all-round talented lady, painter. This is a particular favourite. I think the lyric is incredibly special on this song. And in terms of a masterclass of good lyric writing, I don't think you could go too far better than this.
When you're the person that makes the sign saying you can't put things on top of the pianos, you have to take it seriously. Survey my works, you mighty.
Songs are like tattoos, you know, I've been to see before. Crown and anchor me, or let me sail away. Hey blue, here is a song for you, ink on a pen, underneath the skin, an empty we can make it through these waves. Acid, booze, and ass, needles, guns, and grass, lots of laughs, lots of laughs. Everybody's saying that hell's the hippest way to go. Well, I don't think so, but I'm gonna take a look around at the blue. This is the last song in our small bracket, and we chose a song. I actually sang this song the first time when I was 21 at my final assessment for my undergraduate degree at jazz school, and this was a song that one of my tutors had suggested, and I had no idea about the progeny of the song before I sang it. I just thought it was a really beautiful song. It's a song by Stephen Sondheim. It's called I Remember, and it's from a really bizarre television musical called Evening Primrose. And it's important that I tell you the premise of Evening Primrose because I think it adds a beautiful insight to the sophistication of, again, this lyric writing. So Evening Primrose is a story, bear with me here, about a bunch of people trapped inside a department store. And I don't mean like for a day, I mean somehow randomly in this mystical universe these people are forced to live inside a department store. And so this song is sung from the perspective of someone who hasn't seen anything real
that can't be felt or touched inside a shop for years. It was blue as ink, or at least I think. I remember sky, I remember snow, soft as feathers, sharp as thumbtacks, coming down like lint, and it made you squint when the wind would blow, and ice like vinyl on the streets, cold as silver, white as sheets. Rain like strings and changing things like leaves. I remember leaves, green as spearmint, crisp as paper. I remember trees, bare as cold rags, spread like broken umbrellas, and parks and bridges, ponds and zoos, ruddy faces, muddy shoes, and light and noise, and bees and boys and days. But as years go by, there is sort of haze, and the bluest ink isn't really sky, and at times to invite, yeah, we've come in, Charlotte, we've got seats. Time for the last bracket. Charlotte's here, everybody, yay! It's my great pleasure to invite beautiful colleagues Yola Shelley and Zara Villara to the stage.
I'm so glad you didn't do the short people song. But then the emotional girl, right? And I'm crying. Okay, so it's all Naomi Scold and Janine's, if this all goes pear-shaped. So we're going to begin with one of the first of the three Shtit songs I'm going to sing for you tonight. Georgia Shtit is actually the girlfriend of Jason Robert Brown, fact find. And these are three of five songs from the perspective of coping women in New York City. They're not doing particularly well, but they're coping. The first is From the perspective of a widow, and this is I Hardly Remember Your Face.
Okay. Normally your introductions are long.
Oh, no. I'm still thinking I'm back in my lounge with my slippers on.
Oh, you know you're in theatre, Zara, when your furniture's been on stage just as many times as you.
Of light on your skin. professional mezzo-soprano, as well as a voice teacher. So she's kind of got the whole songwriting thing in a bag. Judith Cloud, and this is the first of a set of four songs. And her music is really worth listening to. This is Lament, so it's another happy song.
Those dark
antiques fair in Rhinebeck. I'll just borrow someone's car.
Something happy. And I'm not really very good at happy. I'm a very happy person. Singing happy. So this is kind of my version of happy, which is actually naughty. It's as good as it's gonna get. So this next song comes from a set of songs called Men I Have Known, and that kind of sums it all up. And this is one of the men, and there's no name, just T.S. So it could be Trevor Strong, Tom Silver, I don't know. So make up your own T.S. But anyway, this is T.S. by Elizabeth Raum.
I like his
massive event. I just want to say thank you to my awesome team. And we are so lucky. And do you know, getting to this point, I felt terrible over there. I mean, I was enjoying every minute, but you know, I was singing their songs in my head and my words were disappearing through the ether, and I was thinking, heaven help me. But you know, UC is in really cool hands. And this is only a small taste of us. But I love us. I really love us, and I would love to be in your shoes, actually. Okay, so the last song is another shtit song, and you should listen to them all. They're fantastic. They're really, really good. And then you should buy them from Music Notes, and then you should sing them. And yeah, I like giving orders and instructions to some of my students. So this is the final one. It was the happiest one I could sort of find of the three. And I like symmetry, so I couldn't do it any other way. So this is actually called The Wanting of You. It's not that happy, but it is a student-based song, and clearly she wants someone she shouldn't have. I shall say.
Wonder if it isn't really loneliness that kills you. I think
upon my skin. How did I dare to let you in?